Welcome, YouTube, to the TCAD 10-Minute Take. Today, we are talking about The Equalizer 2.
That's right. Denzel is back. Let me just first start out by saying, even when I asked my wife to go see this movie, I didn't say, hey, you want to go see The Equalizer 2? No. I literally text her, hey, you want to go see Denzel tonight? Because that's what it is.
Yes.
We are going to see Denzel.
Yep. Doesn't matter what the movie is. Doesn't matter what the title is.
No.
I don't even know.
We're going to see Uncle Denzel. We're going to see him do his thing. Okay? And that's really all that matters. Trust me, every black person out there knows what I'm talking about. They all went to see Denzel. Period. Now, onto the movie. I got to say, overall, I enjoyed the movie. I had a good time. My problems with the movie, I think they tried to put a little too much into about an hour and a half-ish or so. They tried to jam a little bit too much. I get what they were going for, but they probably could have parsed it down what's going on and sort of focused on just maybe the main storyline and one sort of side thing that would have been just fine. You know, look, first off, obviously the great stuff is Denzel. Denzel, awesome. He kicks butt, okay? I thought the cast itself was just fine. You had Pedro Pascal, who's from Game of Thrones and Narcos. Mm-hmm. You've got Ashton Sanders, who did an amazing job in Moonlight. If you haven't seen Moonlight, please get out there and see it. And then you've got Melissa Leo, who plays reprises a role as Susan, as Denzel's friend again in this one. And she's great. I mean, all the acting is great. And of course, Denzel. I mean, he's awesome. But my problem is, I think in their quest to sort of show what he's been doing in this time, how he's helping random people, they brought in so much extra stuff that the main storyline probably doesn't kick in till maybe really like halfway through.
Almost.
Yeah. You know? So it's not a problem. I mean, it wasn't something like, oh my goodness, this movie is ruined, but it really slowed things down. And I think people came into this really wanting to see Denzel kind of kick butt the way he did in the first one, almost like from the get-go. And in the sense the movie did, it sort of teased one of his adventures, and then it got into a lull, and so you're waiting for it to build. Basically, how I would repair it was they should have just kept the secondary line with Ashton. His character is Miles. They should have kept that because that got kind of deep, and that could have really gone some awesome places with him. But they just kind of touched and hinted at it. They could have kept that one and then the main plot line. And unfortunately, with the main plot line, it's kind of cliched. You sort of see it coming a mile. At least I did. I knew it was coming. But it's weird that you sort of knew what's coming. But when Denzel is kicking butt, that didn't take anything away from it. I was still incredibly excited, eating my popcorn, just waiting for him. And I think what made it even better was they made him kind of really angry because he's taking this personal. Although I personally wouldn't have wanted what happens to happen because I thought it was, you know, they got rid of a great character, you know, that I thought could have had way more usefulness in, say, future movies. But I understand they wanted to really make it personal since Denzel doesn't have a wife there anymore. So who else does he have but only a couple friends left? Not bad. You know, I sort of understand it. It's okay.
What do you give it?
You know what? I'm going to give this the full price regular. I'm going to give this the full price regular.
All right.
It doesn't need the bells and whistles. You know, you definitely you don't need IMAX. You definitely don't need no 3D, please. You don't need to go crazy. But this is Denzel, and he does not give a bad performance. I thoroughly enjoyed it, mainly just because I'm just waiting for Denzel to do his Denzel. And it didn't matter the shortcomings of the plot. I mean, everybody in the theater at those moments when Denzel was doing Denzel, you either were hearing some sort of applause or like, yeah, or something from some rando people in the theater. I mean, it's hard to fault Denzel when he's kicking butt. So this is definitely full price regular. You know what? I would say you don't even have to wait for a weekend to see it. Just pick any night, run on in there, give Denzel your money. Trust me, I think you will very much enjoy it. This is really definitely a summer popcorn kind of movie. Oh, for sure.
All right. So let me just preface this by saying I saw it yesterday. And when we got to the theater, we were seeing like a nighttime show. It was like 8:40. 7:45, 8 o'clock. But when we were leaving, there was a huge group of like black, middle age and older couples that looked like they just came from church and went to the movie to go see the new Denzel. Like, they're not the type that necessarily goes to movies all the time, but when Denzel has a movie, we're gonna go see Denzel. So then I was like, all right, if Denzel brought out this many people, then it's got to be. I mean, it was definitely solid. My, you know, he and Antoine Fuqua, this was like their fourth film together. And it was definitely, definitely solid. There were some pacing issues that I found. Like, they spent a lot of time with, you know, like slow tracking shots of his solitary apartment and like slow pans over the cityscape. And I felt like they sacrificed a lot of story that they could have put in there, because there were some, like the bad guys. I know it was supposed to be a twist, but because it was such an obvious twist that right. didn't really need the right. Shyamalan treatment, they could have spent more time building that side of it, because then when it came down to what it was and his real adversary for the show, it was almost like they were shadows of characters. Like, they weren't really fully the rest of the crew, and what their job is, what their intentions were, like what they were doing, what that whole thing was about, was left sort of nebulous. And I guess they felt like, you know, there's this whole slate of movies that's out right now that's like the, you know, baby boomer revenge fantasy movies, where you've got like Liam Neeson and his Taken, or we'll see it and be like, oh, this is Denzel's Taken. So this is, you know, the Equalizer. You got John Wick, and you know, it opened super strong with, you know, the different, like, showing his desire to become this kind of a vigilante and now moving into this new thing. But it had not enough. It was like they ran out of plot, or it wasn't as fleshed out as it could have been, and they put in instead beautiful shots. And there were some great shots, like to have, you know, your climax be on an island during a hurricane is a wonderful setup for some really interesting shots and footage. But then once they get there, they have to maintain that kind of intensity, and it kind of drags a little bit in that regard. And I thought his relationship with Miles, like you said, was like super great, and I wanted to know more about what was going on with him and how that was going to play out. And I felt like that was perhaps, like, maybe we could have gotten rid of one or two of those subplots that we had in there that didn't really move the story along. But I liked getting to know this character more about him, like his.
Because that scene in the building with the gun.
Yeah. Whew. Yeah. Ooh. Yeah. But I wanted to know more about that. Like, even if that was the main plot, like dealing with the gang situation, like, that was fantastic. But it definitely, they sacrificed maybe something that could have been a little stronger for something that was more safe, I think.
Yeah, I guess.
So let me just check our little time there. I'm almost 12 seconds. I'm going to say, for me, this one was definitely matinee. I did see a full price regular, but I also would have been happier if I would have been like super stoked if I'd seen this as a matinee. Whereas I was just sort of like, eh.
I think we're in agreement, though.
Yeah, no, worth a theater.
Yeah, absolutely. We're there at the theater because we're going to see Denzel.
Going to see Denzel on the big screen was excellent. Like, he definitely is, you know, like, just a solid, solid performer. Like, even doing, like, physical, you know, I bought it, even though it's absolutely ridiculous that Denzel after a cookout's going to be like doing kung fu on these young guys. Like, I didn't totally matter. didn't matter. I was in it. I was in it when it was Denzel. Yeah, but let me tell you, that movie theater was packed, and we wound up having to sit in the front section, which I never do. But I'm doing it for you guys for the 10-minute take. No, for you guys. Because if I was not doing the show, I would have been like, I'm going to see you tomorrow, Denzel, because listen, that is no way to watch a movie. I'm just going to say, movie theater owners, that first section, I know y'all want to maximize your seats, but that first section is nonsense, especially the first row. Like, who's sitting there watching movies like this? And back and forth like this. You're looking up people's nostrils inside of booty holes. Like, what is that? But anyway, that's our time.
That's the time. I think we agree. We definitely enjoyed this one. This was definitely a full price must see.
Yeah, it had its issues. I would say you'd be happier if you saw it as a matinee. But, you know, definitely see it in the theater. Mm-hmm.
Definitely see it in the theater. It stands out.
And don't forget to click that bell and subscribe, like, and share.
And keep listening to full updates on TCAD on iTunes, Stitcher, Hipcast, and TuneIn Radio.
Now I want some popcorn.